Psych Class, and welcome back to our virtual classroom. However, this time for something a little different because we are not about to have a unit review video today. Today's video is going to be a flex time series. This is just where I take a specific idea or concept from one of the units and I make a short 5 to 10 minute video of that concept, going into a little more detail about it. These videos will also have some interactive themes to help test your knowledge of AP Psychology. So are we ready? Let's get started. So in this video review, we are going to quickly review the modern perspectives just to make sure that we understand them. Then I'm going to introduce you to Bob, who's had one too many run-ins with the law and is now scheduled for court-mandated therapy. But before we talk about Bob, let's get a little refresher on the modern perspectives of psychology. There are going to be several different ways to think about or study human behavior. Psychologists generally tend to identify with a specific perspective while studying behaviors. We are going to see that some researchers solely dedicate their research to one school of thought. This could be a neuroscientist who states that someone is experiencing depressive symptoms as a direct result of an imbalance of brain chemicals, while other psychologists might integrate multiple perspectives while studying behavior. A good example of this would be a clinical therapist using cognitive behavioral therapy while treating generalized anxiety. As you can probably tell in the name, this therapy uses both cognitive techniques and behavioral techniques to achieve the desired goal. So now let's get into a brief description of each of our modern perspectives. The psychodynamic perspective is going to be based on the workings of Sigmund Freud. This perspective places a heavy emphasis on the unconscious mind and childhood experiences in determining our personality. A psychodynamic therapist might explain to Helga that the reason that she shows irrational anger to Arnold because she uses it as a defense mechanism to hide how she really feels about Arnold. Stemming from the works of Abraham Maslow and Carl Rogers, we have the humanistic perspective of psychology. A humanistic therapist might state that a client is depressed because they have some unmet needs in their life, and achieving these needs and acquiring a sense of self-worth will help in alleviating some depressive symptoms. Evolutionary psychologists are going to apply the principles of evolution to the study of behavior. Psychologists who take this approach also believe that psychological processes are all subject to the principle of natural selection, stating that psychological processes that help us adapt to our environment and increase our chance for survival are passed on to future generations, allowing for the offspring to have a better chance at survival. The biological perspective is a way of looking at psychological issues by studying the physical basis of human behavior. Biological psychologists focus on the nervous system, mainly the brain, when studying behavior. A biological psychologist might state that an individual is experiencing hallucinations as a result of an excess of the neurotransmitter dopamine. The cognitive perspective of psychology is going to focus all on our mental processes. These are things such as memory, perception, language, problem solving, and thinking. A cognitive psychologist believes that maladaptive behaviors are a result of an irrational thought process. Imagine Linda is afraid of clowns and experiences panic whenever she sees one. A cognitive psychologist may attempt to find what the activating cause of this fear is in order to change this maladaptive behavior. A sociocultural psychologist looks into how social influences affects individual behavior. For instance, a sociocultural psychologist might look into something like beauty standards in the US and link them to eating disorders such as bulimia and anorexia. The behavioral perspective stems from the research of Ivan Pavlov, John B. Watson, and B.F. Skinner. It's going to focus on how behaviors are acquired and modified by observable environmental conditions. A behavioral psychologist might say that an individual has a phobia of spiders because they learn this trait at a young age while watching their mother being terrified of spiders. Those are our major modern perspectives that are generally referred to and tested on the AP test, but there are some other ones that might be fair game that I do want to talk about. The biopsychosocial model looks at the interconnection between biological, psychological, and environmental factors in determining behavior. This model is very important in explaining things such as stress-related illnesses or human development. Positive psychology, established in 1998 by psychologist Martin Seligman, is a relatively new perspective in the field. Positive psychology emphasizes the good life, or the positive aspects of the human experience that make life worth living. Positive psychology is going to focus both on individual and societal well-being. So, that does it for our modern perspectives. Yeah, I know, that was kind of quick. So if you feel like you're not ready for round two, where I'm going to quiz you a little bit, you might want to go back and do a little extra research on what's confusing you. Alright, so I'm guessing you're ready for Bob now. So let's get into our story. Bob is a 16-year-old who has been in trouble with the law repeatedly. He has broken into houses with his friends and also stolen from loved ones in order to obtain money for drugs. He has previously been caught and given probation, house arrest, and even time in juvie. Every time one sentence is lifted, Bob reverts back to his life of crime. How exactly would a psychologist from each modern perspective explain the behavior of Bob? Alright, so here's what's going to happen next. We're going to take a sneak peek into Bob's therapy session. Multiple therapists from differing perspectives will be attending. These therapists are going to give their explanation for Bob's behavior prior to letting you know what perspective they follow. So it's going to be up to you to guess what perspective you think the therapist follows based on their explanation of Bob's behavior. Also remember, it is possible that one therapist follows more than one perspective of psychology. So are you ready? Alright, let's go! Our first therapist talks with Bob and comes to the conclusion that the reason for Bob's delinquency is that Bob feels the only way he can enjoy his life and be successful is through illegal activities. Our first therapist also states that Bob is doing these things because he grew up in an environment where stealing and drugs were normalized, as Bob's dad used to be a career thief and druggie. So according to our modern perspectives of psychology, what type of therapist did Bob just speak to? Take a few seconds to think about it. If you guessed both the cognitive and behavioral perspective, you are absolutely correct. Bob has the irrational fear that he will not enjoy life if he does not steal, which reflects the cognitive perspective. This can be seen as a maladaptive thought process. Bob was also reinforced to steal because he grew up in an environment where stealing is normalized and rewarded. This can be considered a learned trait, reflecting the behavioral perspective of psychology. Enter our second therapist. After talking to Bob for a while, our second therapist comes to the conclusion that Bob's behavior is the symptom of traumatic brain injury. The therapist found out that when Bob was a child, he fell off of his bike, hitting his head very hard. The result of the brain damage caused Bob to lack emotional empathy, not caring that he is always stealing from others. So, what type of therapist did Bob just see? Take some time to think about it. Did you guess biological psychologist? If you did, you are 100% correct. In this scenario, the therapist is attributing Bob's behavior to his traumatic brain injury, stating that damage to brain structures is causing this behavior, reflecting our biological perspective. Our next therapist states that Bob has no direction in life. From a young age, he had never had any support and no one to guide him. Our therapist believes that if Bob was given a sense of purpose, he would strive to be a better person. So with the minimal amount of information I just gave you, what type of therapist did Bob just talk to? Did you guess humanistic therapist? If you did, you are absolutely correct. Why is that though? Well, humanistic therapists believe that individuals will strive to reach their fullest potential if given the appropriate resources to do so. If the therapist helped Bob find some type of passion or way to improve upon himself, it could help Bob become a better person. Our next therapist finds that Bob does what he does because of the social constraints. In his town, if you don't join a gang and do bad things with your friends, you are exiled from the group. Bob, not wanting to go against this cultural norm, decides to join up with a crew of bad fellas. This therapist also found out that Bob's father, a career thief, left him at a young age. Bob thinks that if he becomes an even greater thief, his father will return. What type of therapist did Bob just meet with? If you said sociocultural and psychodynamic, you are absolutely right. Bob was raised in a culture of thieves, which is why he feels he must do the same thing, reflecting the sociocultural perspective. He also has the childhood experience of his father leaving, which can be explained through our psychodynamic perspective. And there we have Bob. So remember, the modern perspectives are very important to understand in AP psychology. In every single unit we study, we are going to be referencing one or more of the modern perspectives. So it is very important that you become an expert on them early on, so you don't have any difficulties later on in the course. Thanks for tuning in. I will see you guys next time. Peace.